Many of you have probably seen the Oscar-winning movie A Beautiful Mind, starring Russell Crowe as the mathematician John Nash, who won the Nobel Prize in Economics for his contributions to game theory. Now, you don't win the Nobel Prize for figuring out a new way to play checkers or Monopoly. Right? So what do economists mean when we speak of games? The Scottish poet John Donne put it well when he said, "No man is an island, entire of itself." We're all connected to others, and each of those connections is a game. More precisely, a game is any situation with multiple decision makers, we call them players, whose choices impact one another. So you play games not only with your adversaries and competitors, but also with your allies and your loved ones. In fact, there's games all around us in every aspect of our life, affecting our success and our happiness. We play them at school, at home with our families, at work, when we seek medical care. We're surrounded by games. But we're not the only ones. Bacteria are also surrounded by games. And the focus of today's talk is on how we can change the games bacteria play to improve human health. Now, how did I come to think about this problem? I'm not a trained doctor, I'm an economist. Okay, so let me tell you a little bit about my own game theory journey. Okay? It began in the normal way. I was trained in the mathematics of game theory, kind of following in the footsteps of John Nash, okay, and publishing papers that, trust me, you would never want to read. But while I was doing that, I asked my students, if they wanted a good grade, to identify a pressing strategic challenge in the real world, bonus points if all the experts said no possible solution, and then use the game theory approach developed in class to understand the root cause of the problem and brainstorm novel potential solutions. Okay? And they did it time and time again. Okay? So all sorts of challenges. For instance, business problems. And my students are business school students, after all. Such as, how can cell phone companies respond to the rise of mobile payment systems? Or public policy problems? How can school administrators deal with concerns about alcohol abuse on campus? Even foreign policy problems. What can the State Department do about Somali piracy? Okay. My students, time and time again, showed me that game theory works. And they emboldened me to step out of my own comfort zone, throw my own hat into the ring in addressing a wide variety of strategic challenges. So for instance, you may remember in 2013, the US government shut down and we were about to hit this debt ceiling. Well, I thought, well, let's think about that from a game theory point of view. And I shared some ideas on how Congress could change the game they play to avoid such crises in the future while still responsibly controlling the growth of the US debt. More recently, I've spent actually quite a lot of time learning about crop pests, believe it or not, leading to this talk I gave at the University of Nebraska to some of the world's leading experts on the western corn rootworm, an important American crop pest, sharing some ideas on how we could change the game that farmers play with themselves and with this insect to better protect the American corn crop. Okay? And most recently, I've thought about the problem of terrorist kidnapping, and I share some ideas on how to change that game to better rescue hostages and catch the terrorists. So that's been accepted in the New York Times, but they're holding it and hasn't come out yet. So you can keep your eyes peeled for that one.